Hey y'all, Coldfire here, and I will show the locations for all upgrades, missions, lost vehicles, and much more for the brand new SnowRunner map, The Rift. But first, I would love to ask for your subscription. It doesn't cost you absolutely anything, and I guarantee you that will help me so much. This video turned out to be helpful for you. Don't forget to hit like button and subscribe. So no more overdo, let's get started. The absolutely only way to access the Rift map is by Quarry, and to unlock Quarry, you need to finish two Taiga Oil missions. One involving seismic activities and the other is a Howling. You can find more details on how to do those missions on the links below. The fastest way to access Rift is through Zimmergos, then Quarry. So if you have your Gersh unlocked on that map, that should probably be your option. Otherwise, you have to go through Drownlands, then Quarry, and then Rift. Once you are inside the map, you note that there are four watchtowers that are fairly easy to access, so my advice is hit those first before doing further exploration. Although those watchtowers won't give you much information, it will help a lot to plan and see all the roads available. All the three upgrades and the vehicles are hidden, so the watchtowers will not help you there. And let's start with the vehicles. The most notable of them is by far the Tatrine. It's stuck on the river bed. You're gonna need to repair it, refuel it, and winch it away from the water. The full repair will set you back 360 units of items, and you're gonna need 240 units of fuel before finishing the rescue mission. After that, you can just recover that to your garage. The second vehicle of the Rift map is the Step 310E. You also need to repair and haul it. However, for this mission, the hauling is much further away and the terrain is not as easy. To complete the repairs, you're gonna need 278 units of repair and 240 units of fuel. For the final free vehicle on this map, we have the Zix 5368. All you have to do is repair and recover. No hauling required. This little truck is severely damaged and you're gonna need 451 units of repair and 76 units of fuel. We also have three hidden upgrades on this map, being one of them probably the best of all, that is the race suspension for the Voron AE truck, which is an all-rounded amazing truck, and this upgrade makes it even better, so it totally worth the trouble. The upgrade location is the delta of the river on the east side of the map, just next to those rocks. The second upgrade of this list is a great engine called Azov AM4V146. It is compatible with the Yar-87 and the Khan-39 Marshall. For the Khan-39, this engine is almost exactly as the Azov AM4V160 in terms of bars. I'm not 100% sure they have the exact same performance on the real world though, but at least on the paper they are really similar. While for the Yar-87, this engine will set you as a B+ on power to weight ratio. And the third upgrade, and probably the worst of this list, can be found on the southern part of the map, and is the engine LAS6 T195. It can be used for both the Step 310E or the Zix 5368 trucks. For the Step though, it is a very weird choice because it's worse than the stock engine, so I would not advise you to use that. And for the Zix, it's gonna be the second best engine, only behind the IMZ6210. As for buildings, this new map have a resupply point that you can use to grab cement, a scrapyard where you can pick up metal beams, an old lumber yard where you can pick up wooden planks, and thankfully there's also a fuel station very close to the quarry entrance. We have also a handful of missions. Pathfinder 1, all you have to do is reach the northern road, so using a scout is probably advised here. You also have the uplink mission that will ask you to deliver two wooden planks to the base station, and after that you're gonna have to haul two units of metal beams also to the base station. Both of those resources can be easily found nearby, so this mission is a piece of cake. Just be extra careful with the terrain, the north side of this map is a complete disaster. After doing the uplink mission, you'll unlock the data mining one that asks you to deliver a service trailer to the old mines. It's not very far and you can just follow the dirt roads. And finally, we have landside mapping that asks you to visit 6 points, 4 times, so the faster you can go, the better. I would say maybe bring the Khan or even some more stable vehicle here. I don't know, I just would not bring the Tatrin because it's so slow. But leave any comments what you think about all these new missions. I would love to hear your feedback on that. And sadly, there isn't any epic cargo as far as I could tell. So no mission asking you to move some huge loads around, which is a bummer for me at least. And that'll be all for this complete breakdown of the Rift map. I hope this video was helpful. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel because that will help me so much. Thank you for watching and I see you next time.